listening to Mozart. Occasionally I listen to other people. And then I draw. And the purpose is to start at the top of the page and go and finish precisely at the end of the movement or the end of the piece. In effect, it's an exercise. It's like exercising your muscles or exercising your imagination. There are no preconceived stories. You're not telling a story to Mozart. You're just letting what comes out of your pen come out. I like to be alone. I've lived in New York most of my life. When I had my coronary at age 39, I was advised to leave the city, that it probably would be better for me to live in the country. What they didn't know in advising an hysteric to do that was that I would then have to learn how to drive and do all kinds of things which were probably more stimulating for another coronary than they would even imagine. But I lived through that. If you live through doctors, you'll make it, and their advice. So it had to be Connecticut. And I had to be alone, with dogs, and a lot of trees, and places where I could exercise and walk. And Brooklyn was a very confining place. And one always had the sense of the lack of independence or money. You couldn't cross that bridge to get to New York City where you wanted to be, except on those rare occasions when your older sister or your older brother took the time to take you. So you were a prisoner of childhood. Night Kitchen is the book I was eager to get to because whereas Wild Things had satisfied that particular moment, I knew that one of the books had to be about New York and Mickey Mouse and movies, all my favorite things. Those favorite things were King Kong, which I saw 9 million times or felt like. It's a movie I adore. So I was preparing myself for the opera. And I was frustrated because I didn't know if I was going to do this opera. And I was scared. How dare I do this opera? Without any stage experience, you begin with the magic flute. I mean, that's like starting with Hamlet. If you're going to fall on your face, you're really going to fall on your face. I hope to finish them by the end of this month. It's a black and white opera as opposed to the full color of Wild Things. So it's a nice relief to be working in it. Stylistically, it's very different from Wild Things. Wild Things actually is very broad in style, almost comical. And Higgledy is very sere and nostalgic and very much based on my love then of the English illustrators of the 1860s. I know how different it'll be from Wild Things, in every way, scenically and musically, and in every way it'll be different. And it should be, because as twins on a double bill, they should really be very different. I get another 10 years of a few good ideas, then I kick the old bucket. And I don't say that in a depressed way, in a just realistic way, I'd be quite content.